Hello students, welcome to Go Vidya and welcome back to the 1000 important series questions of transformers. So let's move to the first question. A 100 kVA transformer offers maximum efficiency at a load of 80 kilowatts. 0.8 lagging. Its full load iron loss is dash percent of full load copper loss. So we have to calculate the percentage iron loss. So, at the maximum efficiency, in the question they have given the maximum efficiency and the load at 80 kilowatts. So, we have to calculate the iron loss. So in the question they have given nothing but the active power, So, we will calculate the apparent power that is equal to active power by power factor. So, we know the active power that has given is 80 kilowatts by the power factor is 0.8. So, we will get 100 kVA. So, in simple, to calculate the percentage iron loss, the formula is iron loss by copper loss into 100. But in the question they have given the maximum efficiency. What's the condition for the maximum efficiency? Copper loss will be equal to iron loss. Yes or not? Copper loss will be equal to iron loss. So I can substitute 100 kVA by 100 kVA. Into 100. So then I will get the 100%. Clear? So the option A matches with the following question. So let's move to the next question. If a transformer has 50 turns in the primary winding and 10 turns in the secondary winding, what is the reflective resistance if the secondary load resistance is 250 ohms? So we have to calculate the reflective resistance, nothing but transferring the parameters. So, the number of turns in the primary. So, N1 is equal to 50 turns. N2 is equal to 10 turns. And the secondary resistance R2 is 250 ohms. So, now we have to calculate the reflective resistance. So, nothing but transferring the parameters to the primary side. So, I can write R2 dash is equal to R2 into with respect to primary. So, I will write N1 by N2 whole square. So, in the question R2 is 250 ohms. So, 250 into N1 is 50 by 10. So, whole square. So, 25 into 250 you will get 6250 ohms. 6250 ohms. This is nothing but the reflective resistance. So the option C matches with the question. 6250 ohms. So let's move to the next question. If the supply frequency of a transformer is increased, maintaining the supply voltage constant, then in the question the supply frequency is increased, maintaining the supply voltage constant. So, keeping the voltage constant and increasing the frequency, which means V by F ratio is not constant here. Yes or not? If both V and F are reducing simultaneously and V and F are increasing simultaneously, then we can say V by F ratio is constant. Clear? But here keeping the V constant and F is increasing, V by F ratio is not a constant. Then, so let's check that frequency has been increased. So in general we know that, we know a formula that XL is equal to 2 pi FL. So if frequency increases, what happens to XL? Increases. So, magnetizing current I mu is equal to V by XL. Now if XL increases, what happens to I mu? Will decrease. Nothing but the magnetizing current will increase. Sorry, it reduces. Magnetizing current will reduce. So magnetizing current will reduce, nothing but decreases. So let's check the core loss component of currents. So we know the formula, hysteresis loss is directly proportional to V power 1 by 6 by F frequency power 0.6. In the question, if the frequency increases, what happened to the hysteresis loss will decrease. If the hysteresis loss decreases, definitely the I value also will decrease. So the core loss component also decreases because of the hysteresis loss will decrease here as the frequency has been increased. Clear? So both the parameters will decrease here. So we'll check the option, both the components will increase. No, both magnetizing component and the core loss component of currents will decrease. Yes, both will decrease. So the option B matches. As the frequency increases, the magnetizing current and the core loss components of current will decrease. So let's move to the next question. A two-winding single-phase transformer has a voltage regulation of 4.5% at full load. 4.5% at full load and unity power factor. At full load and 0.8 power factor lagging, the voltage regulation will be. So, simple, at 0.8 power factor, what is the voltage regulation is asking. So, we will analyze by drawing a diagram. So, this is a lagging and this side is a leading. So, this is unity power factor 0.50 minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. 1, 2, 3. So here the point to be remembered is voltage regulation will be minimum. Voltage regulation will be minimum at leading loads. So the voltage regulations will be minimum at the leading loads and the voltage regulation will be maximum at lagging loads. And voltage regulation will be positive at unity power factor. So clear? See, when we are moving from unity power factor towards this, the voltage regulation will increase. So the voltage regulation will increase. So in the question, they have given at 0.8 power factor, nothing but it is moving from unity power factor to this side. Then the voltage regulation definitely will increase, nothing but it will increase more than 4.5%. It will increase more than 4.5%. So the answer will be 4.5%, no, it will increase. More than 4.5%, yes, option B matches with the following question. So, we have to remember this, voltage regulation will be minimum at leading loads and will be maximum at lagging loads. Clear? Let's move to the next question. In certain loaded transformer, the secondary voltage is 1/4 of the primary voltage. What is the secondary current? In the simple, so we know V1 I1 is equal to V2 I2. So, in the question, V2 is equal to 1/4 of primary voltage. So, substitute in the above equation, you will get V1 I1 is equal to 1/4 V1 into I2. So, the even V1 will get cancelled. You will get I1 is equal to 1/4 I2. But in the question, they have asked the secondary current. So, with respect to secondary. So, I2 will be equal to 4I1. So, nothing but 4 times of the primary current. So, 1 by 4th of the secondary current. So, 4 times of the primary current. So, the option B matches. Clear? So, let's move to the next question. A 1:5 step up transformer has 120 volts across the primary and 600 ohms resistance across the secondary. Assuming 100% efficiency, the primary current is equal to. So, we know the formula. Before writing the formula, number of turns N1 by N2 is equal to 1 by 5. And 120 volts across the primary. So, across the primary. So, across primary. 120 volts. And 600 ohms across the secondary. So, R2 is equal to 600. So, we have to calculate the primary current. So, R2 dash is equal to N1 by N2 whole square into R2. So, we will get N1 by N2, nothing but 1 by 25 into 600. You will get around 24 ohms. But we have to calculate the current. To calculate the current at the primary current, we know I1 is equal to V1 by 24. I think 5 times. So, we will get the 5 amperes. So, the primary current is 5 amperes. So, let's move to the next question. So, before this, option C matches with that. Next question. During short circuit test on a small transformer, the frequency of applied voltage is increased from 50 Hz to 200 Hz. The copper losses will increase by the factor. So, the frequency has been increased. So, we have to calculate the copper losses. So, let's see. So, in the F1 is 50 Hz, the case 1. So, the frequency has increased to 200 Hz. So, we have to calculate the copper losses. So, in general, we know I is equal to V by Z. V by Z. So, V by R plus JXL. So, we will neglect the resistance here. As not mentioned, neglecting the resistance. So, we will get I is equal to V by XL. So, what is XL here? V by 2 pi FL. So, from this equation, we can conclude that I is inversely proportional to frequency. Yes or not? I is inversely proportional to frequency. But the copper losses is I square R. Yes or not? So, from this we can write C copper losses by P copper losses 1 is equal to I2 square by I1 square. Yes or not? I'll write whole square. That is equal to, it is inversely proportional to the frequency. So, can I write F2 by F1 inversely? I1 by I2 whole square is equal to F2 by I1. But I2 by I1, so sorry. So, this will be F1 by F2. So, P copper losses by P copper 1 is equal to F1 is 50 by 200 whole square. So, we will get 4 times, that is 1 by 16. Yes or not? 1 by 16. So, we have to calculate the losses will increase by the factor of 16 times. Yes or not? Will increase by 16 times. So, the option A matches with the following question. So, let's move to the next question. A single phase transformer 100 kVA 660 volts. 50 Hz is used at a frequency of 25 Hz. What will be the kVA rating at reduced frequency? Assume flux density remains constant. So they are asking, the frequency has reduced, what is the kVA rating? So kVA will be directly proportional to the frequency. So kVA 1 by kVA A2, that is equal to F1 by F2. So in the first case, 50 Hz has given 50 Hz. In the second case, the frequency has reduced to 25 Hz. So we have to calculate the kVA A2 value. So the kVA A1 is 100 kVA. 100 by kVA A2, that is equal to 50 by 25. This 2 times, this 2 is 50. So we will get the kVA A2 value, that is 50 kVA. So kVA is directly proportional to the frequency. So the option C matches with the following question. Clear? So next, move to the next question. If the applied voltage of a certain transformer is increased by 50% and the frequency is reduced by 50%, assuming that the magnetic circuit remains unsaturated, the maximum core flux density. So we have to calculate, so we have to find the core flux density. So in the question, the applied voltage is increased by 50%. Before that, we know that flux density is directly proportional to V by F. So in the question, they have given V2 is equal to increases by 50%. For 100%, if 50% has been increased, so we can write 1.5 V1. Now again, the frequency has been decreased by 50%, nothing but I can write 0.5 F1. So we'll substitute this. So BM1 by BM2 is equal to V1 by V2 into F2 by F1. So V1 is nothing but, so sorry, V1 by 1.5 V1 into 0.5 F1 by F1. So this F1, F1, V1, V1 will be get cancelled. We will get 0.5 by 1.5. So we have to calculate the BM2 value. If it inverse, we will get 3 times of BM1 value. So 3 times of BM1 value. So the option changes to 3 times to the original value. Yes, the maximum core flux density will changes 3 times to the original value. So the option A matches. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.